Were you able to find everything you were looking for today? Okay, perfect. Oh wow, I'm jealous. This is quite the haul. Oh, you, okay. I see. So you forgot your glasses and picked all these out based just off of like what you could see. With deciphering this tinier descriptive text on the backs of the books. That sounds awesome. Yeah, I'd be really happy to help you with that. It's been a slow day today, so yeah, I think this is going to be a good time. Okay, so how did you manage to pick these out? Did you have a list or you just I'm excited to discover with you what you'd like to take home with you. All right, so before we get started, would you happen to have a rewards number in our system? Have you been here before? Okay, cool. Yeah, let's give that number a try. So that's 4, 2, 8, 4. To know that since you have been here before, you are aware that we are a much older storefront and our system works a little differently. Instead of scanning the barcodes of the books, we instead reference the ISBN number. I have to tell it to the system. And it'll pull up all the price info for us and tell us about any sales or promotions we might be able to give you. Add it to your receipt and subtract one from our store inventory. Looks like your first selection was Gregory Maguire's Wild Winter Swan. I love the font that they chose for this cover. It kind of reminds me of Roald Dahl. And then there's this hand poised with the fingertips holding up a snow globe with a cityscape, and it's snowing. A bird flying overhead. I can see why you picked this one up. Let's see how you a poignant coming-of-age story inspired by Hans Christian Andersen's The Wild Swans, set amid the magic of Christmas in 1960s New York. That sounds fun. I like vintage books set in the past. Laura lives on the Upper East Side of Manhattan in an aging brownstone with her old-world grandparents, but she may sent to a boarding school in Montreal after being expelled from school for behavior unbecoming of a young lady, constantly telling herself stories about the events surrounding the divorce herself through the tragedies of her life. Laura truly finds herself inside a fairy tale when a handsome boy with a swan wing in place of a left arm lands on her roof. But Laura must forge unlikely allies in her quest to keep this storybook character from overturning her life in all the wrong ways. Gregory Maguire conjures a haunting tale of magical realism that illuminates one young woman's heartbreak and hope as she begins the inevitable journey to adulthood. An enchanting, tender, and often funny coming-of-age story whose perceptive truths about the human condition surprise and delight. What do you think? Does that one sound like a good fit for you? Do you tend to like romances and period pieces? Okay, so I'll put that in the yes pile for now. And input the ISBN, which is going to be 7-8-0-9-0-7-9-3. So that one is going to run you $7.99, is that all right? Yeah, I think that's a pretty good deal. The next book I see on your stack is World of Wonders. In praise of fireflies, whale sharks, and other astonishments, this book is about to shake the earth. Places home, the grounds of a Kansas mental institution where a Filipina mother was a doctor, the open skies and tall mountains of Arizona, where she hiked with her Indian father, and the chillier climate of Western New York, where she built a family of her own. But no matter where she was transplanted, no matter how awkward the fit or forbidding the landscape, she was able to sell me on a book with pictures. Oh, you're beating me to it. I've been wanting to read this for a while. So, this is Alex Phoebe's More Do. I love this sketchy, inky, scratchy art style on the cover. International praise for More Do. Usually the back has all of these sort of like testimonials of other authors recommending it, but I think that the author's own summary tends to give me a better idea of whether or not I'll actually enjoy the book. How about you? Okay, so let's try to stick to those. In the slums of the sea-battered city, the young Nathan Dreeves lives with his parents, eking out a meager existence by picking treasures from the living mud and the half-formed, short-lived creatures it spawns. Until one day, his desperate mother sells him to the mysterious Master of More Do. The Master derives his magical power from feeding on the corpse of God. But Nathan, despite his fear and lowly station, has his own strength, and it is greater than the Master has ever known. Great enough to destroy everything the Master has built, if only Nathan can discover how to use it. So it is that the Master begins to scheme against him, and Nathan must fight his way through the betrayals, secrets, and vendettas of the city where God was murdered and darkness reigns. Propulsive, compulsively readable, full of unforgettable characters, and a talking dog who wants to be a philosopher, More Do is an epic fantasy, strange, new, and terrifyingly alive. Heard great things, so I think that you'll really enjoy, and you'll have to come back and tell me all about it. Let me know if I should buy it for myself, or maybe just lend me yours. I love it when books have these special edges with gold or red. So you picked up The Reverie. Warhammer horror novel. Is this part of an already ongoing series? Oh, okay. Wow, yeah, that text on the back is barely legible, huh? I do like the font that they picked for the inside. Isn't that pretty? I think it suits the in the river. Your next selection is a much shorter story. I love those. It can be scary to commit to an epic saga. Sometimes you just want to curl up with one book for the evening. Enjoy it from start to finish. This is The Empress of Salt. Very pretty cover art. A young royal from the far north is sent south for a political marriage in an empire reminiscent of Imperial China. Her brothers are dead, her armies and their war mammoths long. Pretty hefty, especially compared to that last one. But those are great, they really let you get fully immersed in the story. Cass Brecker and his crew have just pulled off a heist so daring, even they didn't think they'd survive. But instead of divvying up a fat reward, they're right back to fighting for their lives. Double-crossed. This is one of my all-time favorite books, which I'm embarrassed to admit because it is a YA novel. which most might say I've aged out of, but I disagree. I'm so disappointed that she didn't decide to prolong it into a series. Understanding, but disappointed. So if you leave this shop with any book at all today, it better be this one. Maggie Stiefeder. The Scorpio Races. It's about horse races. You don't need to be into the equestrian world to appreciate it, because it takes place in a fantasy world where these horse races include a lot more insane drama and violence and magic than you might expect. Some race to win, others race to survive. It happens at the start of every November. Scorpio races. Riders attempt to keep hold of their water horses long enough to make it to the finish line. Some riders live, others die. At age 19, Sean Kendrick is the returning champion. He's a young man of few words, and if he has any fears, he keeps them buried deep where no one else can see. Never meant to ride in the Scorpio races, but fate hasn't given her much of a choice. So she enters the competition, the first girl to ever do so. She's in no way prepared for what is about to happen. I loved it so much. You can see one of this one's going to be a $9.99. What do you think about that? Okay, good. Glad to hear it. Well worth it, in my opinion. If you don't like it, come back. Full refund is yours. From finding inspiration to capturing a giant furnace detail, a step-by-step guide to fairy art. I like the the title text. This gorgeous fairy lounge surrounded by 1, 2, 3 lots and lots of leaves and butterflies. Lots of wonderful references in here with all mediums. Drawing and painting fairies is a delightful and eternally popular art form that poses its own unique challenges. How do you paint an imaginary subject? How can you capture the luminosity and tiny detail of a figure that might fit into the palm of your hand? I didn't know we carried these anymore. You must have found this one, like, fallen behind a bookshelf. The Advanced Dungeons and Dragons Monsters Manual. Let's see. Need a monster? Look inside. We're more than 300 new pieces of full-color art to show what the monsters really look like. This book contains more than 600 monsters, including all the creatures from the Monstrous Compendium, Volumes 1 and 2. In addition, there are monsters from other compendium volumes and some creatures never seen in the second edition AD&D game before. I love when such a bounty of stats. Such a bounty of stats are included. Leaving nothing to the imagination. For all the creatures, you can find out all about their climate, terrain, organization, activity cycle, diet, intelligence, structure, alignment, bearing armor class, movement, hit dice, damage attacks, special attacks, defenses, magic resistance, size, experience. Last book, bottom of your pile, is the Disney's Storybook Collection. It's the hardback collection of all the bedtime stories you could possibly desire. Experience the wonder of Disney classics in this collection of 23 of the best love stories of all time. These short, easy to read retellings of classic Disney films will entertain little ones both day and night. And on the back, you're surrounded by a bounty of long adored Disney characters. It's Peter Pan, Peter, Wendy, Tinkerbell, and then them all flying off into and with a sprinkle of pixie dust from Tinkerbell, they soared through the skies of London, all the way to Peter's Neverland home. Down below, they saw waterfalls and Mermaid Lagoon. There was a pirate ship, a forest, and even an Indian camp. The pirate ship belonged to a fellow called Captain Hook. The captain had two enemies in Neverland. Peter and a hungry crocodile. This looks like a lot of fun. Very nostalgic. So it looks like we're sending with your Disney storybook collection. Your Monstrous Manual Advanced Dungeons and Dragons game accessory. Your fairy drawing and painting. There's the Crooked Kingdom. It's hefty, might take you a while to get through it, but I think it'll be worth it. The Empress of Salt and Fortune. evening read. Of wonders. This will be a nice mood cleanser, mood booster, after indulging a lot of these deeper, darker tales. And your final purchase, a wild. I think I'm going to pick this one up for myself. I've been long overdue for a wintry period romance. With the mystical fantasy touches, of course. So, allow me to just add up your total. Perfect.